Hello guys, my name is Kiki and in this video I'm going to continue working on my Amazon return box. The next item is a Logitech G703, which is a wireless gaming mouse. And this has again a scroll issue like the previous Logitech mouse. Let me show you. Good news that here we have a receiver, a wireless receiver. So let me plug it in. We do not need the cable, it's just for charging. So I plugged it in now. Yeah, it definitely helps if you turn it on at first. And I can see already that it's moving. Let me show you as well. I will switch over. So as you can see, the mouse is moving, but it's not scrolling. I'm spinning the wheel, but it's not scrolling at all. Let's see if the middle button. Yes, the middle button works, because I could open this here. Right button also works. Left button also works. This back button also works. So we only have a no scroll issue here. So let me switch over to the. So let's take it apart and let's see what's the problem. And I assume now it comes apart. Yeah, it looks like the front we might have some pins maybe. Yeah, this one came off. Take care with this ribbon cable here, so I will disconnect it immediately. Okay, and okay, it's just here. You only have some switches for all these additional buttons. And here is our scroll wheel. Let's remove this battery case, maybe we will see better. And a super small battery inside. Let's disconnect it. And here we are. It's a quite simple mouse compared to the other one I worked on. And our issue is most probably here. Let's remove these two screws, which is fixing here the wheel assembly and the encoder here. Okay, I could just lift off, and okay, I can already see what is the problem. Here we should have a shaft for the mouse, which broke off, and it's stuck inside here. Okay. This is bad news, definitely bad news. Because it's a pretty tiny space. And this is definitely something I cannot 3D print. At this, it's just, and it's still moving perfectly fine. Let's see if I can pull it off. Yes. it just broke off. I could try to glue it back, but as you can see, this surface here is really, really tiny. And it would just break in no time, I'm 100% sure. And it's a hexagonized shape, I don't know if you can see, maybe yes. It's a hexagonized shape. The other side is just simple. But here we have to fit the shaft inside this hexagonal shaped encoder. Okay guys, so what I'm going to do now, I will look online if I can find a replacement wheel for this. But to be honest, I'm quite hopeless here, but okay, let's check and I will be back. So I am back after roughly 30 minutes later. I checked it online and it's definitely possible to buy a replacement wheel from this, but unfortunately only from China. But then I have an idea. And it's the following. So here you can see that there is basically a tube. And from the middle of this tube we have the shaft which broke off. How can I show this to you? Yeah. As you can see, it broke off in a rectangular shape, or there are some spikes. Four spikes which broke off from there. And what is my idea? I printed a 3D printed a part. This shape fits inside this 3D printed part, and the 3D printed part fits inside this tube. And if I glue everything together, then I'm quite convinced that this will be stronger than the factory solution, because this piece will basically give a support to the entire material. And if I glue it in, and in addition I have this shape which fits to the shaft, how it broke off, it will eliminate it to slip inside, and for sure also the glue will also help. So at first let me put it together. This is the second trial. The first one was a little bit small, so it was not a tight fit, it was slightly loose inside this tube. So I reprinted it in 102% size, so 2% bigger size. And then now I will put this plastic shaft inside this part, and as you can see it fits perfectly well. And because of this rectangular, these spikes or edges, it's not spinning at all inside. And this one now nicely fits into this. And here we are. So at first I will not glue it in. I'm just interested in if it works. So let's put it back together. Because we should have enough friction just to try. And yes, I'm pretty sure it works. It works perfectly fine. Maybe you can see now, this is the hexagonal end of the shaft, and if I spin the wheel, it's nicely spinning the encoder. Do you know what? I'm quite convinced that this will work perfectly, so I will just glue this in. I will grab my super glue. And I will also put here all around, inside. And also here. And to the end of the shaft. And I have to be fast. Let's put it in. I will press it in. And just fast I will put it back to its position, because I'm interested in if it's well, if it's fully concentric. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. Okay. I will just let it dry for a minute. I will not pull it out now. I will just leave it inside. As you can see, it's moving really, really nice. I'm quite happy how it turned out. I think I should be able to test it harder this way without the buttons. So I will just connect up the battery. Okay. Let's turn it on. It does turn on. And look at this, guys. I'm scrolling. Haha. Cool. Also the middle button press still works perfectly fine. So as I told, I'm pretty sure this is a better solution than the factory, because now the thin part of the shaft is supported by this 3D printed part. So it will last for a long time, I'm pretty sure. Let's put it fully together. Okay guys, and we are done. It works perfectly well. It scrolls really, really nicely. I'm really happy how it turned out. I definitely have to buy new these bottom pads, but I saw them online that it's definitely possible to replace them. So this was not an electrical fix, but a mechanical one, but I think it was quite interesting, especially because I could find a solution with this 3D printed part, and we could save this nice gaming mouse. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If yes, please don't forget to like the video, subscribe to my channel, and I hope I see you next time. Bye!